In this video, we're going to be going over the inner glow feature available in STYLISM by Astute Graphics. Here I've got some basic artwork drawn out, and I just want to head over here to the STYLISM panel and show you this section here. This is where you're able to apply all the different effects onto your selected artwork. So while I have this artwork selected, I'm going to come over here in this panel and check out this button here. This is for the inner glow live effect. When I click on it, it automatically applies an inner glow to my artwork. It also activated my stylism tool here in the tools panel. And if we take a look here in the appearance panel, you see it added the default inner glow that ships with Adobe Illustrator. I'll hide out this appearance panel and take a look at these annotations you see here on my artwork. This guy here on the left is going to control the blur amount. By default, it's set at 5 pixels, but if I click and drag towards the center, you see it'll reduce the pixel amount all the way to 0 pixels. When I release, you see it updated here on my artwork. I'll click and drag and bring it towards the edge, and you see it maxes out this blur at 144 pixels. When I release, you see the effects here. I'll just leave it somewhere right here in the middle. Next, I want to come over here to this slider. This slider is going to affect the opacity. Right now it's set for 75%, and if I click and drag towards the edge, you see it brings the opacity to 100%. When I release, you see this starts off at 100% opacity. I'll click and drag and bring it towards the center, and now you see it has an opacity of 0%. When I release, you see it's updated here on my artwork. Just bring it back right around here somewhere. And so far I've been using these sliders to make my adjustments, but sometimes these sliders might move a little bit too fast for the edits I want to make. So if that's the case, all I have to do is enter the command key, and you see it actually slows down that slider for me. So when I release, it'll make that update for me. I'll show you how to do that again. What you want to do is hover over the handle, click and drag, and then introduce the command key on a Mac or control on a PC, and it'll slow down that slider for you. Once you release, you see your artwork's updated. You can also double click on one of these handles and it'll bring up a panel so you could enter a specific amount in that panel. Watch, I'll show you again. I could double click here on this opacity one and change this to 30%. And when I hit enter, you see my annotation shows it's reflected on the screen. Next, you could actually change the color of your glow. If you click on this swatch, it'll bring up your color picker and you could choose a new color for your glow. When I click OK, you see it's been updated here on my artboard. We also have some blending modes associated with your color. So if you wanted to change over to maybe overlay, you can do that really easy just by using this drop-down menu. I'm going to bring the opacity up a bit and then head over here to the stylism panel. In here, you have the option of changing your resolution manually. So I'll enter at 20 ppi and you see it updates here. But you also have these two presets. One of them is here for 300 ppi and I'm going to leave mine set to 72 ppi. And you could actually change these presets, and we'll have a resolution video that covers all that in great detail. And there you have it, folks. That's the inner glow feature available in STYLISM by Astute Graphics.